Welcome back to Fallout 4.
Jackson's waiting to talk to you, and I'm not throwing the switch until he gives us the go-ahead.
Elder.
Remarkable work, Knight. The signal interceptor appears to be complete. Are you ready to put it to the test?
Absolutely. I'm ready to go.
Your confidence is an inspiration to us all. That being said, this is the first time we've attempted to directly adapt Institute technology. When we throw that switch, we don't know exactly what's going to happen. God willing, you'll end up inside the Institute. And the mission can continue.
What are the details of my mission?
I'm glad you asked. Now, I want you to listen very carefully. Once you've entered the Institute, we expect to lose contact. So it's imperative you remember everything I'm about to tell you. About 10 years ago, the Brotherhood began recruiting civilian scientists from the Capital Wasteland to assist with various projects. During this process, we were able to obtain the services of Dr. Madison Lee, a noted mind in the field of nuclear engineering.
By recruiting, you mean they forced her to join?
Being at war leaves little room for compassion. That said, Dr. Lee's contributions to our cause were instrumental in maintaining order in the Capital Wasteland. After some time, she developed differences with the Brotherhood and exiled herself to the Commonwealth. We're fairly certain that her intent was to make contact with the Institute.
She was a valuable resource. It was a mistake to let her leave.
Agreed. I wish our predecessors would have had your foresight. Your mission is simple. Once you're inside the Institute, we want you to track down Dr. Lee's whereabouts. If you find out that she's still alive, make contact with her and convince her to return to the Brotherhood of Steel. There's a special project we're working on. And it needs her attention.
I want to know what to do if she refuses.
Nothing that would provoke a hostile response. If she refuses, you're not to press the issue. Remember, infiltration of the Institute is our larger goal. Listen to me, Knight. I'm well aware that you're risking your life going into the Institute blind. Just keep your mind on the mission. And don't let anything they say sway you from your duty. Good luck.
Excuse me, Proctor Ingram.
I've checked and rechecked everything. I think the signal interceptor's ready to go. Are you?
Let's do this.
All right. Head up onto the platform and we'll see if I can find a signal to lock onto. The device doesn't work from over there. You have to be on the platform. Let's see. Relays dialed in. Beam emitters warmed up. Everything looks green. Let me start scanning for the signal. Cross your fingers. I'm inputting the code now. Wow, there's a heck of a lot of interference and ghosting. It's gonna take a minute or two to lock in. By the way, this little trip you're taking is a heck of an opportunity to find out as much as we can about the Institute and what they're up to. I put a clever little program on this holotape that'll scan their network and download anything it finds. If you place it in any terminal down there, it'll do the rest. Bring it back to me and I'll see if I can make sense of whatever it found. Well, well, Looks like we have a winner. RF wave capture complete. Ramping the emitter.
Move
60%. 80%. Emitter spiking but steady. All that's left is to throw the transmit switch. Transmitting in 3, 2, 1. Stay safe, soldier.
Refrain from opening fire inside the exit.
I wondered if you might make it here. You're quite resourceful. I'm known as Father. The Institute is under my guidance. I know why you're here. I'd like to discuss things with you face to face. Please, step into the elevator. I can only imagine what you've heard, what you think of us. I'd like to show you that you may have the wrong impression. Welcome to the Institute. This is the reality of the Institute. This place, these people, the work we do. For over 100 years, we've dedicated ourselves to humanity's survival. Decades of research, countless experiments and trials, a shared vision of how science can help shape the future. It has never been easy, and our actions are often misinterpreted by those above ground. Someday, perhaps, we can show them what we've accomplished. But for now, we must remain underground. There's too much at stake here to risk it all. As you've seen, things above are unstable. I'd like to talk to you about what we can do for everyone. But that can wait. You are here for a specific, very personal reason. You are here for your son.
Sean?
Huh? Yes, I'm Sean.
Sean? Is that really you?
Who are you?
Sean, it's me. I'm your dad.
Father, what's going on? What's happening?
Yes, it's me, your dad. I'm here, Sean.
What's going on? Father? Father!
Shh. It'll be okay, Sean. I'm here now.
I don't know you. Go away. Father! Father, help me! There's someone here! Help me!
Who is Father? Where is he?
Father? Father, help me! He's trying to take me! Father? Father, help me!
Sean.
S923, recall code Cirrus. Fascinating, but disappointing. The child's responses were not at all what I anticipated. He's a prototype, you understand. We're only just now beginning to explore the effects of extreme emotional stimuli. Please try and keep an open mind. I recognize that you are emotional, and that your journey here has been fraught with challenges. Let's start anew. I am Father. Welcome to the Institute.
I could kill you. Right here. Right now.
Yes. Yes, you could. And I would be powerless to stop you.
I'll make this very simple. Where is my son?
He's here, in the Institute. Closer than you think. But I need you to realize that this situation is far more complicated than you could have imagined. You have traveled very far, and suffered a great deal to find your son. Well, your tenacity and dedication have been rewarded. It's good to finally meet you, after all this time. It's me. I am Sean. I am your son.
Bullshit.
Is it? After all the things you've seen and experienced in the Commonwealth? Think about it.
Caleb, is it that old?
You had no concept of the passage of time. You were released from your pod and went searching for the son you'd lost. But then you learned that your son was no longer an infant, but a 10-year-old boy. You believed that 10 years had passed. Is it really so hard to accept that it was not 10, but 60 years? That is the reality. And here I am, raised by the Institute, and now its leader.
It wasn't right, what they did. Taking you from me like that.
To you, that would certainly seem true. But to the Institute, it made all the sense in the world. At that time, the year 2227, the Institute had made great strides in synth production. But it was never enough. Scientific curiosity and the goal of perfection drove them ever onward. What they wanted was the perfect machine. So they followed the best example thus far. The human being, walking, talking, fully articulate, capable of anything.
So the weird science experiments needed specimens. That's why they took you.
In a manner of speaking, yes. The Institute endeavored to create synthetic organics. The most logical starting point, of course, was human DNA. Plenty of that was available, of course. But it had all become corrupted. In this wasteland, radiation affected everyone. Even in their attempts to shield themselves from the world above, members of the Institute had been exposed. Another source was necessary. But then the Institute found me. After discovering records from Vault 111, an infant, frozen in time, protected from the radiation-induced mutations that had crept into every other human cell in the Commonwealth. I was exactly what they needed. And so it was my DNA that became the basis of the synthetic organics used to create every human-like synth you see today. I am their father. Through science, we are family. The synths, me, and you.
I don't believe you. There's no way any of this is true.
I wish there was something to say. I know this isn't what you want. But it's the only truth I can offer you.
You're lying. I know it.
Why would I lie? What would I have to gain from it? I assure you, this is the truth. I've shown you my trust. Your weapons haven't been confiscated, and I stand unarmed before you. Please, let's just talk.
We have nothing to talk about.
I had certainly hoped we could work together. But every man must make his own decisions. If you choose to leave, I cannot force you to stay. Understand, though, that I cannot allow you to remain within the Institute. You may have safe passage back to the relay, where you will be sent back to the surface. But from that point, you must be considered hostile. I am sorry. I must think first of the safety of the Institute. And in the cruel world that has developed, those who are not with us are against us. The elevator will return you to the relay.
No way to pick this. Sean, can we talk about this?
Have you reconsidered your decision?
Sean, isn't there some other option? Some other way we can work things out?
You've seen the Commonwealth. You must have some idea of how this world works. You're either with us or you're not. I'm afraid it's that simple.
Wow, this is a difficult decision.
Are you following?
Forget it. Never mind.
I see. Well, as I've said, you may see yourself out.
Only family has left. Why he lives for?
Sean, can we talk about this?
Have you reconsidered your decision?
And I have to work with him. I can't fight him. It's my son.
Changed my mind. I'll work with you.
Well, that's good to hear. All right, then. The Institute is now your home, as much as it is mine. Please take some time, get to know it. Meet the people you'll be working with. You'll want to introduce yourself to the division heads. Dr. Fillmore in Facilities. Dr. Ayo in SRB. Dr. Holdren in Bioscience. And finally, Dr. Lee in Advanced Systems. They've all been notified of your arrival, of course. Meet them, and then we'll discuss what comes next.
Sean, about this synth.
You mean the child? It's a fascinating project, really. There are issues to be solved, of course, but we've made remarkable progress.
You made a child synth. That looks like you. It's an abomination.
It's a synth. Not a human being. A simulacrum. Try to be more open-minded. I'll make sure it's brought back online in the near future. You'll have an opportunity to interact with him further. But I'll admit I'm curious. As a parent looking for a child, looking for the younger version of me, what do you think? Do you think you could love him? Like you would a real boy?
It's not you. It's not even human. I could never love that.
No, perhaps not. But in many ways, he matches what you've been searching for all this time. I wouldn't claim to know everything you're feeling, but if in some small way the boy's presence can help, I hope you'll keep an open mind.
Sean.
I couldn't be more proud of what we've achieved.
Thank you.
broken.
Must have went the wrong way. I was prepared to kill. Turns out he was my son. And I had a feeling that would come up. Is it gonna stop on the floor that I want? Why doesn't it stop there? I cannot fight my son.
Busted.
Oh.
It's an honor to have you here, sir.
Hey there.
Good to see you.
Almost done. Just need to tighten up this primary drive servo.
That's the third primary drive breakdown this month. As far as I'm concerned, the phase-out on these older models can't come soon enough.
Oh, I don't know. Most of them have lasted long past their projected lifespans. If you ask me, they were built pretty well.
I can't argue with that. Even so, I'm ready to see the full Gen 3 roll out.
There we go. All set. Unit, you can return to duty.
Thanks again.
Of course.
Scanning. Unknown identity. Clearance confirmed.
Our technology must seem pretty advanced by your standards.
Excuse me, Doctor.
They weren't kidding. You really are here. Well, all right. I'm Allie. Allie Fillmore. You can think of me as the Institute's chief engineer. When Father told us about you, I could hardly believe it. You've been through so much, I think most people would have just given up. If you don't mind my asking, what was it that kept you going all that time?
I just wanted to find my son and keep him safe.
Now that you've found him, I hope you're proud of the great man he grew up to be. Now, I'll give you a quick rundown of the facilities division, and then I'll answer any questions you might have afterward. As you might guess, we keep the Institute's mechanical and electrical systems running smoothly. We maintain and upgrade all of the systems that make it possible to live and work in a place like this. There's a lot of machinery behind these walls that recycles the air and water and provides power to the laboratories and quarters. The work we do might not be as exciting as some of the other departments, but it's at least as important. So, now that you're here and you've spoken to Father, does that mean you're on board?
I'm not on board with anything.
No? And yet here you are, poking around. One might find that suspicious. If you're not planning on staying, I'd recommend keeping your hands to yourself. Wouldn't want to give the impression you're up to something. And consider having another talk with Sean. He really is anxious to have you with us. If there's anything else you'd like to know about the facilities division, I'm happy to discuss it.
I'm good for now. Thanks.
Goodbye, then.
Greetings. As the Institute's requisition vendor, I can provide supplies for your missions on the surface. How may I assist you today?
I've got a few minutes to browse.
It's my responsibility to make sure this place runs smooth.
I wish you could have known Father as we have.
Yeah, I don't like this. Gotta get that guy's thing. Gotta mark on my radar. Still help the Brotherhood? I don't know. Now I actually don't know why I'm taking all that anymore. I don't need ceramic anymore.
Sweet.
That looks like a tripwire. Can't remember which one is. Oh, there we go. I don't trust this area, it looks like it's gonna shock me. It's fine.
Got it.
worth it for the stim pack. The textures on it. That was weird. To use a gun because I can't reach them. Sugar bombs, you can't eat sugar bombs.
Sweet.
Scanners detecting sentient life. Alert level elevated. Engaging.
It's the nipple twister. Get away from me.
Engaging hostile.
Ah, they killed a cat.
Yes. No way I could pick this. Through.
Personal record, Dr. Brian Virgil. This will likely be my last recording. My requests to shut down the FEV program had repeatedly been denied. We've learned nothing useful in the last 10 years. Why does Father insist on continuing it? If he won't see reason, then I have to take matters into my own hands. What we're doing, it's not right. It needs to stop. If anyone should find this after I'm gone. Know that I never wanted to hurt anyone. Anyone! Do you understand me? I'm gonna make sure the whole program is shut down. If not for good, then at least for years to come. After that, I know what I'm about to do will be seen as a betrayal. Treason, he'll probably call it. So, I'm leaving. I have a plan. And if it works, I'll be somewhere safe. Somewhere not even the coursers can find me. Everything that we've done, the lives we've taken. If there is a God, may he have mercy on us all.
is Dr. Elliot reporting for the Bioscience Division. March 2224. We just received another batch of subjects, but as my previous report stated, we're at an impasse here. More of the same won't help. The two most promising strains of FEV have been adapted to an ideal state, but we're still missing something. I am officially echoing the team's position. The most likely progress for our research on synthetic organics requires new avenues of exploration. Additional Commonwealth subjects will not help. It's the same problem across the board, exposure to too much radiation. We need something, someone new. There's a proposal we'll be putting forward. I am not entirely comfortable with it, but it seems the best course.
Alright, enough of this. Let's just go straight forward.
It's great to have you here. Please resist any urge you might feel to eat the specimens in the hydroponic garden.
Hey, Doc.
Welcome. So good to have you here. Dr. Clayton Holdren, head of the Bioscience Division. I can't wait for you to see the work we're doing. It's truly amazing.
I'm sure it's fascinating, but that's not why I'm here.
Of course. I completely understand. Before you go, at least let me give you a brief overview of what we do here. I promise I'll keep it short. As the name implies, the Bioscience Division specializes in fields of study such as botany, genetics, and medicine. Our most important directive is to ensure the health and well-being of everyone in the Institute. To that end, we cultivate highly specialized breeds of flora for use in food and medicine. We've even started to explore the idea of synthetic animal life. You probably saw the gorillas. They're really just a pet project at this point, but the potential is exciting nonetheless.
Sounds like a waste of time to me. You should create something more useful.
It's just my opinion, of course, but I don't believe that every discovery needs to be useful. Sometimes we innovate for no other reason than to learn what's possible. I'm sure I've taken up enough of your time as it is, but I have to ask, have you decided whether you'll join us?
I'm not sure. Right now, I'm just trying to keep an open mind.
It's a big decision, I know, but it's also a rare and important opportunity. No need to rush to judgment. In any case, I imagine you'll want to continue looking around. Or, if you prefer, I'd be happy to answer any questions you might have.
You mentioned medical care. I might need that from time to time.
In that case, you'll want to introduce yourself to Dr. Dean Volkert. He's our top biologist and also serves as the Institute's resident physician. Dr. Volkert works in the infirmary. Just pay him a visit whenever you need to. You won't find better medical care anywhere else in the Commonwealth. I'll promise you that.
Sorry, but I'm too preoccupied with chit-chat.
Excuse me, Doctor.
Yes, yes, I'm sure that whatever you have to say is very interesting, but now simply isn't the time.
If you're busy, that's one thing, but I don't care for your tone.
My tone? There's no need to take offense. As you can clearly see, I'm deeply involved in some rather complicated mental equations. Now, how about I get back to those, and you get back to whatever it is you're doing?
Why doesn't it give me an option to punch him?
Those mental equations will get a lot tougher after I suck you in the jaw.
What? Now, just a moment. There's no need to get angry. If an apology will suffice to stem your anger, then I'll offer it. So nice talking to you. Goodbye.
The latest synth generation is just amazing.
You can actually say I'm sorry. Bastard. There's the gorillas.
Dr. Holdren's synth gorilla project is showing promising results. You're here. Glad you made it.
Synth gorillas. Everything will be machines at this rate. No, what the Institute's doing is not right. It will replace humans. It will replace all life on Earth with synthetics.
Is it true Food Supplement 77 has been discontinued?
That is correct.
That was my favorite one. Can't we keep it a little longer?
I will be happy to forward your request to the Bioscience Division. In the meantime, please feel free to enjoy one of our other nutritious and flavorful food supplements.
I want Supplement 77.
I am sorry, sir, but that supplement is no longer available.
Useless machine.
She's been at it for over 2 hours. What is she even testing?
Nothing. At this point, she's just doing it for fun.
Hi.
Yes?
Free bullets? Why not?
That was productive. Sleep is such a waste of time. I'd rather be designing more efficient plasma emitters.
Doctor.
Hmm? Oh, hi there. Sorry if I seem distracted. I memorized 5 sets of design schematics and now I'm doing detailed mental comparisons.
Nobody can memorize a dozen blueprints.
I didn't say it was easy, but I've been practicing at it since I was a little girl. Anyway, I'm glad you're here. I just wanted to say how much I admire Father, and that it's an honor to meet you. I really hope you'll stay here with us.
Synth relay grenade.
Safety first. Remember that.
Doc.
Since you're new here, you should take time to learn our safety procedures. And the sooner the better. Rules create order, and order promotes efficiency.
How many rules are we talking about here?
Not nearly enough, if you ask me. I had some handbooks made up, but that was years ago. I'll see about getting one to you.
Sure, whatever.
Take care, then.
Dr. Lee.
Oh, it's you. You're not authorized to be here.
I wasn't aware that I needed authorization.
Father may have given you the keys to the castle, but this is still my laboratory. If you plan to stay down here with us, you need to learn how things work.
What are you working on?
There's no getting rid of you, is there? You're obviously here for a reason, and you've already spoiled my experiment, so you might as well spit it out.
Let's just say that you've regained the attention of a certain group that I represent.
Stop beating around the bush. It's obvious that you're from the Brotherhood of Steel. I knew it was just a matter of time before your people would track me down. I've been looking over my shoulder for almost a decade, waiting for them to send someone like you to kill me.
If I wanted to kill you, we wouldn't be talking.
That's a fair point. Since Father trusts you, I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt. I might not agree with everything he says, but I know he'd never allow harm to come my way. Say what you came here to say, and then leave me alone.
You should return to the Brotherhood.
Even if I wanted to return to them, why would they want me back?
Did you abandon any projects you wanted to complete?
You should know better than to ask me that. If they didn't tell you what I was working on, they didn't want you to know. I'm certainly not going to put my neck on the line and spread their dirty little secrets. Tell me something. Why would I possibly want to come crawling back to the Brotherhood? What reason would I have to throw away everything I've accomplished here?
The Institute is deceiving you.
So now you're just gonna hurl baseless accusations to get what you want? Come on, you can do better than that.
I was just told to get you to come back.
The Brotherhood wants me back, and the best they can do is send a robot that does nothing but follow orders? Sorry, but you're going to have to do a lot better than that.
I give up. What would it take to convince you?
All right, I'll play your game. I had a colleague down here, a Dr. Virgil. Several months ago, there was an accident in his lab, and he was killed. I wanted to help with the investigation, but Father had the laboratory sealed, saying that it was contaminated. The incident never sat right with me. The more I asked about it, the more I felt like Father was deflecting my questions. If you bring me solid information on what killed him, I'll take it as a favor from the Brotherhood and consider your offer. Do we have a deal?
I know this may come as a shock, but Dr. Virgil is still alive. I met him myself.
Oh, please. Do you really think a cheap tactic like that is going to work on someone like me? Stop trying to avoid the legwork by lying. Either you get me the evidence, or we have nothing else to talk about. Deal?
Yeah.
I already have something that might convince you.
How did you... Never mind. Just let me see what you've got.
Here you go.
A holotape. This better not be a waste of my time. They lied to me. They lied to me, and I didn't even realize how far it went. All those years of loyalty. For nothing.
Is this enough to convince you?
More than enough. I came to the Institute to get away from the Brotherhood. From the whole world. I just wanted to do my research in peace. Father took me in and gave me access to cutting-edge technology that I only dreamed existed. I became jaded. I thought that the Institute cared, that they wanted to better mankind. Maybe in their own twisted way they still do. But now I realize if you can't trust the people you're working for, then it's all pointless. If they lied about Dr. Virgil, who knows what else they've been lying about? Or what their plans are for my work? I'll make my way back to the Brotherhood, but I'm going to have to do it on my own. I can't take any chances being seen with you. Tell whoever sent you that they've just regained the services of Dr. Madison Lee.
Dr. Lee.
I'll be along soon. Just tell whoever sent you to prepare for my arrival.
Do you have security codes to any of the other sections?
Here. This is everything I have. It's not much, but you can use them however you like. Anything else?
I wish you'd come with me now.
That would be dangerous. If we're seen together, it could jeopardize everything. Father would never willingly allow me to leave the Institute. I made it from the Capital Wasteland to the Commonwealth on my own, you know. I can take care of myself. Now, is there anything else? I need to prepare to leave.
How are you going to get back to the surface?
Let's just say I still have a few people I can rely on in here, including someone that knows how to operate the teleportation system. Don't worry, I'll keep my word. Was there anything else? I need to get my things together.
Good luck, Doctor.
To both of us.
Trial 6. The last week has been very productive, but exhausting. I think we'll need a break after this. Binet has done some really marvelous work with the personality mesh. It's almost too good. The responses map almost identically to expectations, some of the most lifelike I've seen. Of course, it's not really Sean. None of his memories are in there. That, even now, would be a step too far. It's starting to have an effect on the team, I think. I know I've been caught up in the moment once or twice. Just a second or two, forgetting that he's not a real boy. Still, I think we'll need to consider restricting him to the lab only for the moment. I'm well aware that others are put off by his presence. If I were slightly more arrogant, I might consider that a sign of success.
We'll start the next trial, then. The dosage will be much larger this time, and the side effects will likely be more pronounced.
Will there be any pain?
I honestly don't know. I suppose it's your job to find out. Now hold still. There. All good. You can return to your duties, and remember to record every symptom you experience in detail.
I hope I'll prove a useful test subject for you, Doctor.
Mm-hmm. I have to admit, the third generation sensor really is something.
Hi.
Once you've settled in, I'll want to do a physical and get a file going. No hurry, though.
No offense, pal, but I'm not letting a complete stranger poke and prod me.
I don't expect you to trust me right away. What I can tell you is this. The medical treatments of your time are nothing compared to what we can do here. How about you take some time to get comfortable, learn the lay of the land and such? In the meantime, you come see me if you need to get patched up. We'll do that checkup when you're good and ready. Take care of yourself, so I don't have to.
Protocol, sir. Authorized personnel only.
So Dr. Ayo thinks he can hide in his office, doesn't he?
Well, you can tell him that I intend to speak to Father about these unannounced security sweeps of yours. Ransacking my quarters in the middle of the night is totally unacceptable.
I'll pass along your message, Doctor.
See that you do.
Hi, Doc.
Welcome. Welcome. It is so good to meet you. I truly hope you'll come to think of the Institute as your home.
The only place I want to call home was destroyed. A long time ago.
I'm truly sorry. This must all be terribly difficult for you. You should know that many of us consider it a great honor to have you here.
Nothing to report, sir.
Yes, I'm a courser.
Seriously thinking of heading over to robotics to knock some heads together.
What now?
They're dragging their feet on the targeting package upgrades I asked for.
We're all looking forward to working with you.
With me. You'll send a message.
Please don't. There's enough friction as it is between us and pretty much all the other departments.
You going soft on me, Alana? My methods get results, and they will this time as well. You'll see. Courses on the hunt are relentless. If you see one, should stay out of its way.
Doctor.
So, here you are.
Just for now. Acting director of the Synth Retention Bureau. I'll be up front with you. We're going to be keeping a close eye on you for the near future. Despite your relation to Father, you're a bit of an unknown quantity. I'm sure you understand. There won't be any issues, will there?
Stay out of my way, or you'll regret it.
That sounds a bit like a threat. I'm sure I'm just misunderstanding you, though. Threats aren't advisable for someone in your position. Now, Father has asked that I provide you with a brief overview of the Synth Retention. Our primary responsibility is the recovery of escaped Synths that are hiding among the human population on the surface.
If the Synths want to be free, you should let them.
Synths do not want. They might look like human beings, but they're machines. As to why they're escaping? That matter is currently under investigation. Our main instrument is the Courser, a third-generation Synth assigned to operate on the surface. Coursers hunt down and reclaim Synths that have escaped the Institute. They are highly self-sufficient, trained in combat, infiltration, and tracking. In a word, our Coursers are relentless. But I gather you know all this, since you've encountered it already. In fact, I'd very much like to know how you defeated it.
I hate to break it to you, but your Courser wasn't all that tough.
Then it's likely the unit was defective. It's rare, but faults can occur from time to time. I suppose I'll have to ask robotics to perform detailed diagnostics on the entire production run. As if we don't have enough problems. Now, unless you need something else, I'll get back to work.
You mentioned that Coursers undergo special training. Tell me more about it.
The SRB constantly monitors our Gen 3 Synth population, looking for specific traits. Those who show tenacity, fearlessness, and independence undergo a rigorous training regimen. We teach them armed and unarmed combat, investigative techniques, psychology, and mechanical skills. Those who pass a final evaluation become Coursers. The rest have their memories wiped and return to their former duties.
Always be vigilant. We have many enemies.
Good to see you. I know it'll be a difficult adjustment for you, but try to remember that Synths aren't people.
I swear I spend half my time smoothing the feathers that Justin ruffles. We need to be able to collaborate with the other divisions, and that's a lot harder when they're always angry at us.
A little friction between departments is normal. You'll work through it.
Yeah, I guess that's true. Oh, just listen to me. It's the first chance we've had to get acquainted, and all I want to do is complain. In any case, it was good to meet you.
Hi there.
Oh. Weapons. 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 Oh, that doesn't look good. Looks like that'll hurt quite a bit. Yeah, come on, let's just head back.
I give up.
All right, I had a
sure.
Several months. I wanted the incident. If you bring, do we have it?
I know this may come.
No, stop.
Deal.
All right. Dr. Virgil, I can get...
Uh-huh.
I'd tell you to be quiet. And finally, now, for the sake of keeping up appearances, let me see that Pip-Boy. I've been told to install a Courser chip in it for you. Father's orders. You're to be given full access, with the ability to relay in and out of the instant.
Right.
That seems kind of a...
I assure you, it's necessary.
Uh-huh.
In case the significance is lost on you, you'll be the only one here with that kind. If nothing else, it should dim... Speaking of...
Tell the others to be on high alert. More patrols and more rounds.
Right away, sir.
If you see anything even remotely suspicious, report it immediately. This absolutely cannot happen again. Got it?
Yes,
Doctor.
Sir.
You know what happens when people get robots to do all their work? They get fat and lazy. Real people doing...
Someone's bitter. I don't see any harm in robots helping.
Robots helping out? You make it... What's being planned here?
Blah, blah,
you've
blah.
Just arrived. In any case, perhaps a
Whatever.
If you require maintenance, please file a report with the Facilities Division.
Hello.
Find the control software and use an update.
If it were just a limb twitching, but her eyes were moving as well. Involuntary twitching and rapid eye movements while sleeping can only mean one thing. You just don't want to admit to yourself what you mean.
If you're about to launch into one of your impassioned speeches about artificial sentience and machines with souls, don't bother. I've heard enough of them by now. I'll wipe them down from memory.
But we can't just ignore the question. If a synth can dream, why can't it have a soul? And if a synth has a soul, then it is a living person by every standard we can measure. Of course it is far more comfortable to think of them as machines, so we can do what we want with them.
If you disapprove of the work we do here, Dr. McKay, you know where to find the teleport.
Just a moment. I never said that. I'm simply trying to open everyone's eyes to new possibilities.
Well, it's an unwanted distraction.
It's just remarkable.
We're men of science, not philosophers. You do well to remember that. With our third generation synths, we've improved upon humanity.
Hey, Doc.
You've arrived at a momentous time. Our third generation synths are a true breakthrough. The culmination of centuries of research. It's no exaggeration to say that they're superior in almost every way to human beings.
No robot is superior to me.
You might not think so now, but just wait. You've only seen a fraction of what our synths can do. Their potential is limitless. Like I said, a momentous time.
Another lovely day, isn't it? Father's a great man. You must be very proud. It's you. You're finally with us. I'd just like to apologize for any trouble our synths may have caused for you. They, of course, couldn't be told of your identity. They have very specific protocols for protecting themselves. Most of which are designed myself. Not to make problems for you, though. Will you be staying with us then?
I'm thinking it over.
Well, I hope you do decide to stay. It would mean a great deal to Sean. If you require anything, especially as it pertains to synths, please let me know.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello. Welcome.
I'm
Please, step new forward. Here. Processing. Process for synth creation should not be interrupted.
I hear we're about to get a new food supply.
Hopefully I can now leave. I think that was something behind me.
Well, I'm glad to see the relay didn't completely vaporize you.
Did you expect it to?
No, of course not. It was far more likely that it would just blow up. But it didn't. You made it in. Were you able to find the serum?
Got it right here.
That's it. That's really it. All right. Let's see. Retrovirus has matured nicely. Density gradient is high. Recombinant counter-intron sequences look stable. Transcriptive exon strands have formed.
So it's good.
There's only one way to find out.
gonna use it here.
And now, we wait.
It didn't work.
Give it time. The retrovirus has to run its course. I'm going to rest for a while. I'm back in a few days, maybe a week, and... well, I guess we'll see. In any event, you kept your end of our bargain. Thank you.
Protect and serve.
Good to see you.
Father has done remarkable things. I would not exist were it not for him.
Greetings. As the Institute's requisition vendor, I can provide supplies for your missions on the surface. How may I assist you today?
I'll take a look, sure.
I'm gonna sell you back your weapons.
I can't express how truly humbling it is to stand in your presence.
Now that you've had a chance to...
Son.
Now that you've had a chance to see the Institute firsthand.
Son.
What do you think?
Not even Sean.
First things first. How do I get back to the surface?
The same way you got in, of course. You are not a prisoner here. You may come and go as you please. Ultimately, all our knowledge and resources are focused on a single goal. The goal is best summarized by our motto. Mankind. Redefined. Unfortunately, no advancement comes without occasional setbacks. As remarkable as our synths are, they can be... dangerous without proper supervision. The superior synth mind and body attempting to wrestle with something approaching free will can be a recipe for chaos.
If they're so dangerous, you should destroy them and start over with a better design.
There is no need for such drastic action. We are constantly working to correct any flaws that might arise. As you will soon see, we're also more than capable of reclaiming any synths that become a danger to the surface. A rogue synth has taken over the Raider gang at Libertalia. His memories have been erased, and his identity altered. He believes he's a man named Gabriel. Under his leadership, the Raiders have taken many innocent lives. I've dispatched a courser to Libertalia. I'd like you to join him and reclaim that synth.
It might not want to talk. It would be safer just to kill it.
That would be a terrible waste of a valuable resource. If at all possible, that synth should be returned alive. Now you should get moving. Many people are in danger, and a delay could cost lives.
Sean,
you should get going. There's no time to waste.
I'm going back to the Brotherhood first.